Well, boys and girls, this is your old friend, the Dreamfinder, here to set off on another grand circle tour of the Magic Kingdom.
The future is bright indeed. We're all of us dreaming of the better days ahead, and a part of your bright new future could be a move to where the magic lives in the greater Orlando area of Florida. One of the biggest decisions you'll make when considering a move is selecting a realtor who can successfully match you with the right home in the right location at the right price. Victor Naraki is the realtor who can help you make the move you've always wanted to. Whether you're a first-time homeowner or looking to move near Disney World, Victor is in your corner. If you are looking for an experienced real estate agent covering all of Central Florida, please visit DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com today and find out just why you should work with Victor. I encourage you to create a free, no-obligation account on his website. By doing so, you'll unlock the website's full potential and be able to enter specific criteria, save listings, and browse new properties sent to your email. Visit DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com today or visit his Facebook page, Victor Naraki Realtor. And don't forget to tell him the Grand Circle Tour podcast sent you.
Hey, gang, welcome to another exciting Detour episode of the Grand Circle Tour podcast. And I just realized we're doing a Detour show, not a regular show, and I played the wrong intro. So for those of you that are just joining us, we've been doing this for about half an hour already, and I played the wrong intro three times. So this is not, I think we'll just keep this one.
Even the pros make mistakes, right?
I don't know what's going on with me today. Should we play the intro now? The Detour intro now?
Nah.
Let's play the Detour intro now. Here's the real intro, folks.
Yeah. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the Grand Circle Tour podcast proudly presents our spectacular festival pageant of thoughts and laughs. Using thousands of bytes of computer dialects and electrosynthomagnetic personalities. The Grand Circle Tour Podcast Detour Show.
Welcome to this very special Detour edition of the Grand Circle Tour podcast. I am Stan Solo, your host today, screwing up big time. And joining me today are two favorite co-hosts of mine. Let's start off with Food Fairy Kris while she's in the middle of laughing. Kris, how are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
I am amazing, but you already know. Ask.
At least she doesn't have food in her mouth while she's laughing. Yeah, really.
I say I'm amazing, but honestly, I think this is our take three, and we decided just to go with take three because take one and two were a disaster.
Just go with it.
I think it's the roughest start I've ever had to a podcast.
It makes me so happy to know that you, Mr. Professional Podcaster, is messing up. So yeah, when I mess up, I won't feel as bad.
And then you can say, oh, Stan does it too. So it's fine.
Yeah, so it makes me feel much better.
Yes.
I think of myself more of an expert. And the definition of an expert, an ex is a has-been, and a spurt is a drip under pressure. I'm basically a has-been drip under pressure is what I am. Today, my other favorite co-host, Ringmaster Holly. Welcome to the show, and how are you today?
I'm doing pretty good for a Monday.
Monday's my favorite day, as you can tell.
It is?
The kids are home from school today, so it's weird.
Do your kids ever go to school? It's like every time I talk to you there.
It was canceled last Thursday because it was too windy. You know, us Californians don't know what weather is. They're like, oh no, it's windy, let's cancel school. And then today and tomorrow it's canceled because the teachers need to do work without the students there.
Oh. So. Yeah, we had 70-mile-an-hour wind gusts here, and they still went to school.
I think ours was 20 miles an hour. It was pretty bad, but, okay. I mean, it's pretty crazy.
-22 degrees Fahrenheit here, and everything's open still.
Okay, yeah, put it this way. A few years ago, school was canceled for a solar eclipse. Okay. So...
It's California.
They were worried the kids were going to be distracted and looking, trying to look at the sun all day.
Okay, so when I was in junior high, there was a solar eclipse, and we had school, but they let us outside to at least see the solar eclipse. Like, it was like we took a midday break.
Yeah, like you would think that it would be like something to learn about.
Educational, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Which, by the way, was the only day in the history of my entire school career that I skipped, because I actually went home during the solar eclipse to watch the solar eclipse at home with a friend of mine who had a telescope, and we had pictures.
Cool.
And yeah.
Yeah. But that's cool.
Mm-hmm. My mom and dad were there and all that. So,
yeah. But so, how are you, Stan?
Oh, man. If it wasn't for all these mistakes, I'd be amazing.
oh, stop it. Not that big of a deal.
Oh, my God.
Jeez. Alrighty. So I want to make sure I don't hit the wrong button next. I got to see. Where am I? Okay. Now, we're going to talk about the Disney 100th. Now, is it? It's the Disney Company 100th or Disneyland's 100th? What is it we're talking
company.
About?
Disneyland's 100th.
No, yeah.
Disney Company. I'm not alive to see that, actually.
or is it the Mickey Mouse's 100th? No, it's the Disney Company.
Yes. Company, yeah.
Company. Okay.
1920.
We're going to talk about that.
I believe it's technically in October.
Yeah.
But they decided to start it now just so they could be really confused with Epcot's 40th, Walt Disney World's 50th, or Magic Kingdom's 50th. They decided, let's just really make everything chaotic.
Alrighty. Let's talk about that right after this.
Want in on a little secret? Becky and her team with MEI Travel can book you the trip of your dreams, all based on your budget. With over 100 agents working around the clock to get you the vacation you dreamed of. Whether it's Disney or elsewhere, there is never a fee for their services. And she even has experts that can book you Universal as well as all cruise lines. Visit www.mei-travel.com for details. And don't forget to tell them the Grand Circle Tour Podcast sent you.
Okay, we're back. Right, so before our break, we were talking about the 100th and what it all entails. So, like Holly said, okay, so Holly, you said it's technically in October, but we're going to start now. Is it because it's too windy in California and they're afraid people won't go? So they're giving them reason to go? Like,
obviously.
Oh, my God.
Why are they starting it now? Because to coincide with Mickey and Minnie's? In California?
I guess just because it's in 2023, and yep. They want to capitalize on it as much as possible.
Well, of course, they're capitalizing on that. Yes, that's the key word.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, I was kind of surprised because when we were going to D23 Expo last year, I was expecting to hear a lot about the Disney 100 and everything mm-hmm. that's going to be coming out. And I was, it was like, it's going to be the Disney 100th. D23 Expo special, like, you know, part of the reason why people were going, there wasn't much. Like, I left not knowing much more.
When we were at the MEI booth and we were watching on the TV there, because we couldn't get into the panel, and they were going over everything that's coming for the 100th, I was in tears because, first of all, that video was very cute and touching, but I was so excited because I felt like Disneyland was going to be just popping with everything. It was going to be so incredible. Like, it was going to be almost a brand new park and all this stuff. And yes, there is a lot of stuff, but I was there on Friday from open to almost close. Shocking. I did not make it to close. I was dead tired. But it wasn't what I thought it was going to be based on that announcement that they did at D23. So.
So when you got in, obviously they gave you free pins and free hats, like they tend to do when it's a big celebration. Okay,
so we stayed the night across the street, and we had the most incredible view. The whole like wall of the hotel room opened up. It was like those big like windows, the sliding glass, whole walls. Right there was Incredicoaster, all of that, right across the street. Mm-hmm. That's where we stayed. I didn't fall asleep until 2:30 because I was so excited because they were testing the fireworks. They tested the fireworks later or earlier in the evening, but they were testing World of Color all night. They had a crane out there. They were making announcements on the speakers, talking back and forth. And we kept hearing like dump it, like loud noises. And they're like, those are our buttons. They're dumping our buttons into the thing. Like, those are the buttons they're going to give away. Like, every time we heard a noise or an announcement from the cast members talking back and forth on the speakers, I jump up out of bed to go. I'm like, I could never stay here for like a week. I would be dead
because it would be exhausted.
Yes, because they just kept testing everything and it was so cool. But,
so, okay, now, so, were you awake because you couldn't sleep because of the noise or because you didn't want to sleep because of the excitement?
I didn't want to sleep. I kept wanting to see what they were doing. What were they doing with the crane? What were they lifting? Like, it was so exciting that, yeah, that hotel was amazing, but that would not be a good place for me to stay because I would never sleep.
What was the name of the hotel? I'm curious.
It's the Westin, and it was gorgeous.
So that'd be a great place to stay the night that they're putting up the Christmas decorations.
Oh my gosh. Kind
of, could you imagine being able to stay up all night?
Crazy,
and just watch
that view. Yeah. Oh my goodness. So we got up. I got up at 5:30. So I got like 2.5 hours sleep. So we could be there at opening to get a button or something. To our shock, there wasn't. It was just very surprising to me because even for Mickey and Minnie's or Mickey's birthday, they gave out little cute birthday buttons. So
Disney Plus, they gave us ears and buttons.
Yeah, so to me, it was really shocking just because of all the media. There was so much media there that they didn't do a button. So I said, oh, well, let's go get one of the celebration.
Well, they put them in the World of Color Lake while you were sleeping, that's why.
Yeah, so I said, let's go get a celebration button and say that we're celebrating not getting a button. Like, but so when we walked into the park that morning, the whole hub was covered in like those big screens when they're recording, you know, for the lighting, and there was media all around, you know, where they have, I don't know what that area is called, but where they usually stick the Christmas tree and the hearts for Valentine's Day and all of that. So they had placed a Mickey Mouse there, like an iridescent colored Mickey Mouse.
This is at the beginning of Main Street.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Right in the circle. Not the hub, the circle right there. Yeah. And they had it blocked off. And so when I walked in, I wanted a photo of the Mickey Mouse. Well, I actually got reprimanded because you can't stop and you can't take photos because they were doing media right there, which, sorry, but I thought that was a little bit ridiculous because I was there in the park for all the festivities for that day. And I couldn't get a photo of the famous Mickey Mouse that they had just placed there for the event. And so I didn't even realize.
So this Mickey Mouse is like the 100 statues that they had at
Disney World. Yeah, I have a photo. I don't know what it says at the bottom. Yeah, I think it says 100. I'll have to look at it. But it's not the same one that you and I saw at D23. They placed that one in Downtown Disney. And that one is like 3 times larger than the one that they placed right there on Main Street, which is surprising.
Weird.
Yeah, that is strange.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So when we walked in, I'm trying to video everything because I will tell you, it was really cool though. They did have a lot of cast members lining the streets, clapping with bubble machines, which that's why I like going to these opening day things, even though it's chaotic and exhausting, but because of the cast members and how exciting and the energy that they make these events. Mm-hmm. So obviously the 100th was starting, as well as Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway opened on Friday as well. So two huge things for Disneyland, in my opinion. And that's why really...
Toontown reopening. Along
Toontown is opening March 8th. So they only let you in if you had a Lightning Lane or a boarding group. They blocked it off. You had to show... Yes. So you had to show your phone and show that you had a Lightning Lane or a boarding group to get into Toontown. And it was only that one section where the ride is and Roger Rabbit area.
Is that just for that day or is that going to be until March now?
Until March.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah. Which is very odd to me because that takes a lot of manpower to have people blocking it constantly. Yeah. And I mean, it's still cute. You know, whenever they put up the walls, they always decorate them and make them cute. But I don't know. there's just some things that are just odd to me about all of this. So anyway, so as we're walking in, I'm trying to record everything that's happening and all the media there, and they're, you know, doing, I don't know, live streaming. The news was there, and I was getting, you can hear her on my recording, like, keep moving, no stopping, no, I don't know if she said no video, no, but I was like, wait a second. And then Chip and Dale are walking my way, and I'm trying to get a recording, and then I'm getting yelled at to get out of the way, basically. I'm like,
oh my gosh. And who was yelling at you?
A cast member. To keep moving. This was not a stopping area. I'm like, it isn't? Because this is where you normally do the photos, is right here. But anyways. So the other thing, which was, this was extremely disappointing. So we were talking about this last night on our recording, and I feel like all of us here are pretty professionals as getting boarding groups, right? For all of these virtual queues. We know how to do it. We've done it. Dan even got group number one, which is incredible, for Rise one time. When we just went in June, I got two boarding groups for Guardians. So I am at 100% for getting boarding groups. I did not get a boarding group for Mickey Minnie's Runaway. And it was shocking. I didn't get one at 7 a.m. and I did not get one at 1 p.m. I was absolutely, in fact, my friend was, we were in the hotel still, and my friend was recording me because we thought it was going to be like a celebration. And it's kind of funny because she actually shared it, and she's like, this is where Holly failed us. Like, because my face is like, wait, did this really happen? And I like tilted my phone so she could see that it says, sorry, all whatever are full. And I'm like, what? So we instantly went to Instagram and was reaching out to everybody. Like, did you get one? Hardly anybody we know got a boarding group.
Wow.
So makes you lightning question.
Lane. Lightning lane's available.
So we had to buy a lightning lane so we could ride it. Okay. So here's the other thing too. When we went back to ride it, lightning lane was incredible. It was literally lightning lane. Like, it's not where lightning lane is for other attractions where you still have to wait a little bit. There was, you got right on. You walked right through the queue and got right on. The standby for the boarding groups was, I had a friend wait 2.5 hours after her boarding group was called.
What?
Yes. Okay. So popped up on
that you didn't.
So popped up on the app yesterday. It now says, once you get your boarding group, if you were lucky enough to get one, in print at the bottom, there's a little Mickey hand and it points down and says something like, if you want to bypass the standby line, go ahead and click here to purchase a lightning lane instead of using your boarding group. What? Yeah.
Wow. Interesting. And how much was your lightning lane for that one?
$20.
Ouch. Yeah, that's up there. Yeah.
Wow.
Yep.
Okay.
So going back to the ride, the Lightning Lane queue, you bypass all of the main queue, which is incredible. I think we should do a live show only on the queue for Mickey Minnie's. It is so incredible. You get some really cool posters on the Lightning Lane queue. So the first time we got on, we rode Mickey Minnie's 3 times. The first time we got on...
Hang on, wait a minute. You rode it 3 times. Did you buy 3 lightning lanes?
Nope. It was such a mess. So the first time we rode, we obviously went in the lightning lane. And the posters were great. Took so many photos of those. But we couldn't help but like, oh, what's over there on the main queue? And I don't know, 25 seconds, 30 seconds into the ride, it like suddenly jerked, the lights popped on, and I'm like, oh, it's broken. And oh no, the ride's broken. And my friends who never rode it before, they didn't know that it wasn't part of it. And they're like, it's broken? And I said, well, yeah, the lights are on. within seconds, they made an announcement not saying your buggy has come to a, you know what I mean, a halt and please remain seated. It was a cast member will be with you shortly to assist you. And I'm like, to assist us? So sure enough, right away, we got evacuated. Hmm. It was so strange to me that they didn't even give it the normal 10, 20, 30 minutes of sitting there for them to try to fix it. They evacuated us, and that took a good at least 20 minutes to evacuate everybody because they start at the last train that just left the station and go forward. They get everybody off. They put you in a single file line, and they walk you through the ride to the exit.
Okay, so when you're going through, are the projections all on and still moving, or are they paused? Or
no, everything was on. The lights were on. The music, I don't think there was any music. There was no music on, but everything was still lit up.
The projections weren't moving. Like, the waterfall wasn't going and stuff.
Yeah, I believe it was. I'll have to look at whatever photos I got, because once again, we got yelled at. No recording, no photos, put your cameras down. And so, of course,
just leave your phone at home, but make sure you have it with you all the time.
I know. So, but we're like, if you have your phone out, you could trip and you could get hurt, blah, blah, blah. So anyways, so of course we took some photos and videos and then we would get yelled at. So we left and it was down for quite a while. And I think at 2 o'clock or something, some really late time, they were still only on boarding group 60, which is really bad for 2 p.m.
Now we know why it's 2.5 hour wait.
Yeah. Yep. So my sister was down on a 1-day ticket and she was very sad that she did not get a boarding group at 7 a.m. However, at 1 o'clock, she did get one, but she got group 205. And so later in the day, she got a notice saying, sorry, your boarding group has been canceled. We're not going to get to you. So when we left.
What is it with Disneyland and their openings? Since day one, they've been having problems with openings, opening days.
It's just crazy to me. I don't know how everything works, but to me, it's crazy to have this many issues on opening day because they're testing for months, right?
Yeah.
I don't understand what the problem was with the rides or why it was breaking and why they immediately evacuated everybody, because that takes so much time. Just let us sit. I would have rather sat for 20 minutes or even 30 minutes so they could fix it. So once they escorted us off the ride, they had to scan our tickets. So obviously we could come back. So we had to wait a while before we could go back. And then we went back again, but this time we went to scan in and the guy said, oh, you have lightning lane. And we said, no, but we want to stand in the standby queue because we want to see the queue. And he's like, are you sure? And we're like, yeah. So he said, no problem. But that took, it took at least 45 minutes, going through the queue, which is fine because who knows how long it's going to be another time. It could be longer. It could be 2.5 hours. Like my friend waited yesterday.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. So that was worth it because this queue is incredible. Okay. So we finally get on the ride. We go to take off and it breaks. Barely took off and it breaks.
Hang on. Was Marla with you when you were doing
that? I was going to message her and be like, Marla, are you here? Because what's going on? So then the ride closes for the fireworks. But so they close from 8 to 10 p.m. every night, which is kind of a problem, too. So they didn't open the ride back up until it was after 10, maybe 10, 15, 10, 30. I don't really remember. So that's when we went back for a third time and we got to ride it finally all the way through. Boy. It stopped for a very long time at the very last scene, but I don't know if that was just they were having trouble unloading and loading people or if it broke. I really don't know, but we were already on the last scene.
But you made it through then.
Yeah.
To the
I
have a question though, before you go on, because this is something that you just mentioned. What is the reason why they close it during the fireworks?
Because they have to do, I believe, the fireworks in that area over there, and it's probably too close for, because they have always done that. They always close Toontown. Typically, they close Toontown early in the evening at like 8 p.m., and it's closed for the rest of the night.
Yeah, okay.
But now that brings up a very good question. Are they going to just close it now for the 2 hours every single night and then reopen it again after the fireworks?
Yeah, because that that's a really shortened time to get boarding groups and stuff in there if they're going to have that many a day.
Mm-hmm. Just have to evacuate all of Toontown and then let everybody back in again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kris, were you with me when Mickey Minnie's Runaway Road broke down? Yeah, and remember when somebody lost their hat?
Yes.
Was what it was.
That's what somebody was joking about. We were sitting there.
Kris and I were riding it together. Yeah. And I think Justin was with us too, wasn't
he? Justin was with us too, yeah.
Yeah. So it stopped.
Mm-hmm.
And they told us just to stay in our chairs. And next thing you see a cast member walking and somebody lost their hat and we saw them pick up the hat and then go.
Oh my goodness.
And after a while later, it started up again.
Yep.
Wow, that's crazy. Yeah, who knows? But it shut down numerous times during the day.
I don't remember the opening day at Disney World, Mickey and Minnie's Runaway. I do not remember that happening. Multiple times of it going down. I don't remember that. And
it's so funny when you think about this brand new ride breaking down numerous times, having to be evacuated. I don't know what their protocol is, why they evacuate every time it breaks down, but because my in-laws tried to go later that day too, and they got to the first scene where they play the cartoon and they got evacuated and they gave up. They're like, we're not doing this. Wow. We're not doing what you did. So they didn't even try. And then you look at the last day of Splash Mountain running at Magic Kingdom, the ride that's been there for 400 years and it didn't break down.
Not once.
Yeah, no, ran all day long. Not a
400-year-old water ride. Yeah. A water ride. And then a new trackless top of the line breaks down numerous times on opening day. It's bizarre to me.
Yeah, it is very crazy.
Mind you, on the last day, they were just trying to push people through already at Splash. I mean, people were falling out and they were just telling them to swim home. they didn't care anymore at that point.
We're just going to keep going.
Yeah, scoop your water up on your way down as you're swimming out.
You're flooded, you know.
Yeah, both were sinking. They didn't care. They were just pushing people through as much as they could.
Oh my gosh.
So what else? The 100th Disneyland, they've got like a ton of food options. They got special merchandise. They also had the opening for the 100th. Were you able to see the opening for the 100th? Were you there for that?
I didn't. I completely missed that. I only saw it on Instagram. I never saw that. So unfortunately, I was still looking for my button. I was looking all over, so I missed the opening ceremony.
What type of food options do they have going on there? Is it the same old fare, or is there anything that stands out that you tried?
It was pretty much the same stuff that we talked about on our live show a couple weeks ago. But they did have some new merchandise. So they had a Mickey Mouse sipper, which is very cute. He's in his, which is weird because the color schemes are really throwing me off, because most everything seemed to be like it was a lavender and then platinum. Mm-hmm. And then the characters come out and they're in a dark, deep purple and platinum. So I don't know. So that was confusing. Mm-hmm. But the sipper's very cute. It's Mickey in his deep, dark purple suit. And so that's cute. And then they had a new tumbler, the one that matches the Magic Key Holder popcorn bucket. It's cartoonish. It's very cute, though. But it has Walt and a lot of the I'll have to show it on the live show. But on the side of it, it says, like, Disney 100. I'm trying to think what else they had. But I don't think there was anything... Go ahead.
They have the dark purple because by the time they finish celebrating the 100th, those outfits are going to be faded to
dirty. And dirty.
Yeah, so they'll be fine by the
end. Yeah, they're going to be sun faded and all sorts of stuff. Yeah.
Okay, and then they did have a cavalcade. I believe it was about 1 o'clock. So that was very cute. Very short and sweet.
It was cute, though. very cute.
It actually made me tear up just because of the announcements that they stated and then the song. So the new soundtrack is fantastic. It is really good. The Wondrous Journey, the new firework spectacular, is incredible, I think. It starts from the very beginning, which I know that's what a lot of people's issue was with the newer one at Magic Kingdom. It just showed all of the new stuff, right? Mm-hmm. So this one starts at the very beginning with a sketch of Mickey Mouse, and it goes through the years. It's very good. Everybody was bawling their eyes out because, once again, the words they use, the songs, very great soundtrack. It was insane packed for the show. And in fact, we found a spot 2.5 hours ahead of time, and we were so far back. 2.5 hours. Wow. The hub was completely filled. Yeah. So about an hour prior to the show, they made an announcement, which we have never heard before. And it was something like, if you're here to enjoy the show, please remain where you are because we are at capacity for viewing areas. There was nowhere to go. Wow. So if you were trying to go somewhere else to find a viewing spot, it said, don't even bother. Yeah, everywhere was happened. Yeah. They did make an announcement too about the going to the Rivers of America, which is not the best spot to view it, but that they were going to do the projections from the show on the waters, you know, the streams of water, kind of like World of Color, to help out with this. So it was crazy. I mean, I've never waited that long for a show. 2.5 hours, that's a lot for me.
Yeah, Disneyland's nighttime spectaculars, they get so packed. It is, there's no moving. Like, if you want to get from Fantasyland to Tomorrowland, you basically have to walk right to the very beginning of Main Street up to the train station, do a U-turn, and then come back up, because they just keep everybody going in a circle around the park in the same direction. Crazy. You're not allowed to backtrack at all.
So
I can only imagine.
It was really good, though. Really good. Gosh, what was I going to say? I totally forgot. Oh, so they had, so normally they used to do just like Tinkerbell, and she would fly on the one little rope from the castle to Matterhorn. That was it, just the one downward. Now they have it where they kind of, they go back and forth above the castle, which is really cool. So that was something new that they did. So they had the blue fairy come out towards the beginning, with the wishing star, which was, I think that's the part that really got me. So she kind of floated over the castle, not just the straight line. And then towards the end, they had Baymax, and he had on his little suit and jets on his feet, and he went across the castle too.
With
the really good, like, victorious song. And so that was really cool too, especially to have two characters flying over. So like I said, the music really changed from the beginning, starting out with, and it even said something like that, here's the beginning, and they showed Snow White and all the original movies, and then it progressed into Baymax and Moana and all of that. So I think that's why it has really appealed to most everybody, because you got everything. And that's what they should do. They should be doing, especially for the 100, starting from the beginnings.
That is very cool. That is very cool. Yeah. Kris, you wanted to talk something about some merchandise that you were looking at.
I was looking up some merchandise because I wanted to see what was available. And I found some. I'm a Pandora girl. I have like 3 Pandora bracelets.
Not the movie, the jewelry.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. not the land in Animal Kingdom. They have a new Pandora bracelet, the one that holds your charms, and it is special for the Disney 100. The clasp itself is a Mickey head, and it has the Disney 100 logo in gold.
Oh, cool.
On that Mickey head. It is not cheap. It's $185 just for that bracelet with nothing.
And how are they normally, the bracelets to start?
I think I paid like $130 maybe.
Okay.
So it's up there. The other thing, Pandora-wise, that I found was an Oswald charm that I'm like, oh my gosh, I just have to get this. I have room for one more dangling my Disney-only bracelet. He's in silver, but his shorts are in gold.
Cute.
And but again, this is up there because of the gold that's in it. It's mm-hmm. 150.
Oh wow.
Most of those dangly charms are 75-ish.
Oh wow.
Around there. So but it is absolutely adorable.
Yeah, you Another never want to lose that bracelet, that's for sure.
Someday I'll tell you this story about the day I did lose my Pandora bracelet at Magic Kingdom. There is a really cute figure available from Target, and it's only $12.99. It looks like it's plastic, but it's really, really cute. Mickey's all in silver, but he's got purple shorts.
Oh, that's cute. I think that's I've really seen that. Cute. Yeah.
And then the other thing that I found that I thought was really cute and very affordable is the Disney 100th Walt in black and white, and he's holding a drawing of the original Mickey Mouse. Right now it's on pre-order for June release of 2023 on Entertainment. That's what it's called. And it's only $11.99. I was kind of shocked that it wasn't more than that. I was expecting it to be in the $20-ish dollar range, but $11.99. So that's really good. So if you want to pre-order it, it's available. So just
and where Google it. Where do you find that one?
It was called Entertainment. Hold on.
Well, that narrows it down.
Real quick. Yeah. Entertainment Earth is the website.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Entertainmentearth.com.
Okay.
So, yeah, it's available for pre-order right now.
That sounds cute.
Yeah, for $11.99. So, there you go.
Very cool. I know when we were at D23 Expo and we were at the movie trailer premiere, everything they were talking about that was coming out for 2023, they started off the show by showing us that little intro that's going to be at the beginning of all the all the Disney movies that are coming out for 2023.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And it's like a new look at the castle, like a new mm-hmm. angle type mm-hmm. thing with the kind of the wishes arch and a Disney 100 on the bottom. That was about the only thing I really took out of D23 Expo that's going to be Disney 100 was that little, and they showed it to us probably about three times. They were so proud of it.
They actually, when we went to the movies several weeks back, on New Year's Eve, they had the preview of the live action Little Mermaid, and they had that before that started.
Yeah.
So that was kind of cool. I mean, I actually, with the music and the graphics and everything of that, and them going into the Little Mermaid, I got the chills. It was just really, mm-hmm. really special. So,
and it's kind of neat how any movie that comes out this year, like years from now, we're going to be able to watch it on Disney Plus or mm-hmm. DVD or whatever the format is at the time.
Yes, and it will.
And
have
they will
that.
Have that Disney 100 thing at the beginning, and we're going to be that came out in 2023 because that's when the 100th was. We're going to know immediately that was a 2023 movie, which is kind of cool.
Yeah, very cool.
So, is Disney World doing anything for the 100th? Have we?
I haven't heard anything either. I mean, I would have expected them to start cavalcades and everything already, at least.
I'm gonna kind of assume that once they're done in March, right, with the 50th, mm-hmm. then maybe they'll bring some things.
Yeah,
I don't know.
It's just very possible.
It's weird. I don't know. It's just weird. There's just so much going on over there.
Honestly, I would think that they would be making a way bigger deal out of this than so far that they have. I don't know.
So I know at D23 they were talking about there's gonna be platinum touches all over Disneyland and the castle and the new shows and I don't know if you guys have seen photos of the castle. Everyone's saying I'm gonna get hate for this. Everyone's saying how beautiful it is and oh my gosh, and when I look at Magic King, the castle there, and all the beautiful, like, it looks like permanent adornments on there, and they're so gorgeous. And then Sleeping Beauty's castle, I swear, has like a rug.
It's just like flags or something, isn't it?
Oh my gosh. Like
a big nickel in the middle with 100 written on it.
Yes. They're just oh gosh. And I know I'm gonna get so much hate for that because everyone's like, oh, it's so gorgeous. And then the fountains are cool. Mm-hmm. But honestly, they look like those little sprinklers that you put in the middle of your yard. Literally a little green like sprinkler with little spigots coming out, and they just turn it on. And it looks really cool, and I think they should leave it there all the time. So I really love that. But it's funny, if you look at it, it's just like a little green like sprinkler spigot in the middle of the moat there. but I don't know. I have to say, I am disappointed comparing it to Cinderella's castle, and it's gorgeous how they have the rose gold. I don't even know what those are called, but I do like the star, the platinum star that they put on Sleeping Beauty's castle. I do love that. But yeah, like you said, a nickel, an iridescent nickel, and a sheet, like, and then a rug hanging on each side. And I'm so sorry, Disney community. I know you're
so. This kind of makes me wonder, now that we're talking about what we think Disney World might be doing, are they going to take all the statues that they put up for the 50th and spray paint all of them platinum?
Okay, I don't know. And then going back to that, they said there's going to be platinum touches all over. There was the small Mickey when you walk in on Main Street, and then they did have a Minnie Mouse over in the hub too. Very cute, but that was it. Is there going to be, I was expecting characters like they did for Magic Kingdom all over the park. Is there more coming, I guess my question is, or is this it? I will definitely take the new fireworks show. It was incredible. That's great. Really happy about that. The new soundtrack through the park, through the promenade is Esplanade is great. But is there more? Is there more coming?
Did you go to California Adventure at all? Anything there? No,
okay. I didn't. There is. They have the bunting all over, the dark purple and the platinum, the silver bunting all over, just as they do on Main Street. And then they have those nickels. That's what I'm going to call them now. The nickels all over too.
The big nickel.
Yeah, and I want to say
that's nickel.
I feel like that's it. And obviously they have the new World of Color show, which I've heard, oh my gosh, it's fantastic. And that was the worst World of Color show I've ever seen. So I need to watch it myself to.
Wow. That's a pretty big disparity there.
Yeah, it really
one
is.
To the other. So that'll be interesting.
You can always count on Disney fans to give their opinion on everything that they
That's for sure.
Good or bad. So
yeah, definitely.
Oh, that's for sure. Anything else we want to touch on here?
Just curious that. You know, what's going to happen? Are they going to add things to this, especially at Disney World, I guess, once March is over with?
I mean, I know at D23, they did say the main focus with the 100 celebration would be at Disneyland. So that's why I was thrilled. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. I will kind of be surprised if they do decorate all of Disney World in the 100, but I'll also be surprised if they don't, you know what I mean? Like, why wouldn't they add some touches, some merchandise?
Well, even the international parks, like I'm looking at Disneyland Paris, well, they're wrapping up their 30th anniversary pretty soon. Are they going to get a few touches of the 100th also? Like, I mean,
now, when are you going?
I'm going in April. In April, I'll be there.
Okay. You'll have to check it out.
Yeah, you'll see firsthand what they do. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, 100, that's huge.
It is huge. Very huge. Yep.
So
I think they should be doing a lot more. So hopefully they're going to add extra stuff. Hopefully.
Yeah.
Alrighty, we're going to pull this ship in. Passengers, what do you think? Does Disney need to do more for the 100th, or are they hitting it on the head and that's all you want to see anyways? It's just what the big nickel on the castle. An amazing firework show. Alrighty, Ken, take us away.
The Grand Circle Tour podcast is brought to you by Expedition Roasters. When you visit expeditionroasters.com, use the promo code Grand Circle Tour Podcast. That's all one word, and you'll receive 10% off of your order. If you would like to keep the adventure going after the show, be sure to like our Facebook friends page, Grand Circle Tour Magical Ticket Holders. While you're on Facebook, like our group page, Grand Circle Tours. Be sure to follow us on Twitter, Grand Circle Tour Podcast, as well as Instagram, GCT Podcast, and our YouTube channel, Grand Circle Tour, and on TikTok at Grand Circle Tour Podcast. That's all one word. If you would like to email us, drop us a line at gctpodcast@gmail.com. T-shirts and other fun merchandise can be found at tpublic.com. Simply search Grand Circle Tour Podcast. If you enjoyed your adventure, leave us a review on Apple Podcast. Only one rule, make it good. All logos, sounds, songs, and music that are made by and for Disney and its affiliates are owned in full by the Disney Corporation and are not, nor are they intended to be owned in any way by the Grand Circle Tour Podcast. Thank you for riding with us, and welcome home.
Please exit to your left by stepping away from the cars with your left foot first. Step out and stand on the moving platform, please.
Please exit by stepping away from the cars with your left foot first. Step out and stand on the moving platform, please.